Hi students, welcome to Plus One Computer class. So we are discussing our last chapter, Internet and Mobile Computing. So the Internet section is over. Internet section, the services, then the threats affected by, and also the protection. How we are protecting your computer from network attack, all the things relating to Internet we completed. Then next we are moving to our another concept. Next section of our chapter, that is Mobile Computing. In the previous video, we discussed about the various prevention methods for computer threat or internet threat. We started with firewall, then after that cookies, then antivirus scanners. And also we discussed the various guidelines for internet access. Okay, general guidelines while we are using internet, what are the different guidelines you want to take care. Then, after that, in this video, we are going to discuss about mobile computing. What is it? Mobile computing. Then, mobile communication. Different generations of mobile computation. We will discuss first generation, second generation, third generation, and fourth generation. Okay. So, that is mobile computing. So, what is our topic? Mobile computing. Our topic is mobile computing. Mobile computing means nowadays we are using mobile phone for accessing internet. So from internet, nowadays in all the mobile phone we can access internet. You want to recharge, then automatically it will be. We already studied the various parts required for internet access. We need an NIC card, network interface card, in your computer or in your device. So after internet, or if the requirement for internet is increasing, so that's why they created a device, small device. Using that small device, we can access internet. We can use it for both the purposes, for transferring voice data and also text data, or for data. So that is belonging to mobile computing. Okay, what is it? Mobile computing. The definition of mobile computing is, it is a communication by opening innovative ways of exchanging information using mobile phones. So we can use mobile phone for accessing internet, for sending emails, for sending files. Using Bluetooth also we can send files. Okay, so all these belonging to mobile computing. Actually, mobile computing is a technology that has computing capability and can transmit, receive data while in motion. While traveling also, we can make use of computer for accessing internet. Okay, then in mobile computing, we are going to discuss the various generations of mobiles. Okay, generations of mobile computing. Generations of mobile computing. Generations of mobile computing. We already studied the various generations of computer. We started with first generation, second generation, third, fourth, and fifth generation. Now we are in fourth generation. Clear? So like computers, mobile phone also having different kinds of generation. Nowadays we are using 4G. 4G means fourth generation. 5G phones also introduced, that means fifth generation phones also now familiar. Okay, so that means these all are based on generation. The first mobile phone was introduced in the year of 1946. Okay, the first mobile phone was introduced in the year of 1946. In the initial stage, the growth in the mobile communication was very slow. At that time, the technological requirement was very less. So that's why the technological improvement is very slow. With the increase in the number of users, again, the development of mobile phone is increased. And nowadays, we can make use of smartphones. Okay, with 5G technology or fifth generation technology. Then, first we will discuss generations of mobile computing starts with first generation. First generation. Then, this is also known as 1G. Then, actually first generation computer developed in 1980. Okay, 1980. 1980, developed mobile phones for voice data. But at that time, the services and the technologies improvement are very less. So that's why in first generation mobile phones, they used only for transferring voice data. But the signal quality is very less. In first generation of mobiles, they used only for transferring voice data, not for transferring data and also informations. Clear? It is the lowest level and it is introduced in 1980. Then, 1G mobile phones were based on analog system and provide basic voice facility. It uses analog signals. Analog signal means, you know about analog signal. Analog will go like this. Analog signal. Okay, so that means it can transfer only voice data. Actually, computer and also mobile phone uses digital format. Digital data means 0 or 1. That's why nowadays picture clarity is very high. Okay, digitalized format. So, first generation computers, a first generation mobile phone introduced in 1980, and at the initial stage, that mobile phones were used only for transferring voice data, and also it uses analog signals. So, that's why basic voice quality will be there. No other special quality is not available in one generation or first generation mobile phones. Then after first generation, second one is second generation is also known as 2G. Okay, second generation is also known as 2G network or 2G mobile communication. In 2G mobile communication, the concept of MMS were introduced. Okay, MMS, that means along with voice data, we can also send MMS. What is MMS? Multimedia messaging service. Multimedia messaging service means we can send pictures. That means along with voice data, we can also transfer MMS. In 2G network follow digital system. Comparing to analog 2G, 2G network provides digital. That means analog is converting it into digital. This improves the audio quality because it is digital. So definitely it will improve the audio quality. Then in 2G network, phone conversations are digitally encrypted. That statement is very, very important. Digitally encrypted. Digitally encrypted means analog signal is converting it into digital format. So that's why it increases the quality of voice. Okay, then one more advantage is, sir, 2G network also introduced the data services for mobile. Data services like picture messages and MMS. In old phones, we can view picture messages, good night, good morning, that kind of small icons will come. That means picture. It will not be original picture like graphics will be there. That kind of picture also we can send. Then MMS, multimedia messaging service also introduced. Then at that time of generation, second generation, there are two concepts were introduced, that is known as GSM and CDMA. What is it? GSM and CDMA. These are the two approaches introduced in second generation mobile, GSM and CDMA. First one is GSM, Global System for Mobile. Global System for Mobiles. Global Systems for Mobiles means digital cellular communication. Digital cellular communication means analog signal. That means the conversation can be encrypted into digital format using global system for. That means the same frequency level we can use for performing so many. Simultaneously we will get call. That is the main advantage, which allows simultaneous call on the same radio frequency. Simultaneous call on same radio frequency. At that time, so many telephone companies were introduced because they also having their own frequency level. Using that frequency level, they can call or they can make use of simultaneous voice calls. That is a specialty of global system for mobile. Same frequency level we can make use of simultaneous phone calls. Then the frequency level also introduced, and at that moment the concept of SIM also introduced. What is SIM? Subscriber identity module. SIM card also introduced in 2G. It's also known as subscriber identity module. Then one more approach is there, that is called CDMA, code division multiple access. Code division multiple access. This concept also introduced in 2G, code division multiple access. That means the several transmitter can send information simultaneously over a single communication channel. Here also they are providing simultaneous access on a single channel, because at that time so many companies were introduced, they are also using their own channel for transferring data. Okay, so the approaches introduced in 2G generation are, first one is global system for mobiles, that is known as GSM. In GSM, they introduce the concept of SIM, subscriber identity module, and the method that we were using in 2G was code division multiple access. What is it? Code division multiple access. Here, they provide a single channel for simultaneous data access. Then the voice quality of CDMA is better than GSM. Okay, voice quality is better than GSM. It has a signal with wider bandwidth and increase the resistance of interference. It provides better security of mobile. Better security of mobile means man in middle attack can't be accessed. So that means it increases the security level. So these all are taking place in second generation of mobile computing. Then after that, 3G. 3G means third generation. In third generation, we can send voice data, MMS, along with we can make use of mobile phone for internet purposes. Okay, 3G wireless network technology provide high data transfer rate for handheld devices, and also it introduce the concept of speed in data transfer rate. That means it improves the downloading speed. Then the high data transfer allow 3G network to offer multimedia services combining voice and data. At that generation onwards, online chatting concept were introduced. Online chatting softwares are available like Skype, Google Meet, so many we are using. That means at same time we can communicate it with voice and also data. This is one of the main advantage of 3G mobile generation. What does that sentence indicate? 3G network offer multimedia services for combining voice and also data. MMS means videos also introduced. In videos, voice and also pictures will be there. Then 3G is also known as wireless broadband, as it has the facility to send and receive large amount of data using mobile phone. And also it is also known as, we studied about mobile broadband. Mobile broadband we can make use of in 3G. That means if we are connecting that mobile phone, we can send or we can increase the data transfer rate. Then the access part in 3G. Okay, in 2G we are using code division multiple access or CDMA. But in 3G we are using WCDMA. That means wide band code division multiple access. That means it increases the geographical level, wide area network, or it in connected to wide area network. That's why it require upgrading the base station and mobile phone. Also the base station need to be close to each other. That means so many towers also introduced on that time for accessing, better accessing of internet. And wide areas, WCDMA connected with wide area network, so that's why data transferring rate also very high. Then these are the different points in 3G. Then one more is 4G, fourth generation. 5G is not present in your textbook, up to 4G is present. In 3G we are using WCDMA, but here we are using ഓർത്തോഗണൽ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി ലെവൽ OFCDMA. ഓർത്തോഗണൽ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി കോഡ് ഡിവിഷൻ, ഓർത്തോഗണൽ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി ഡിവിഷൻ മൾട്ടിപ്പിൾ ആക്സസ്. ഓർത്തോഗണൽ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി മീൻസ് എനി ഡയറക്ഷൻ ഡാറ്റ ട്രാൻസ്ഫർ റേറ്റ് വിൽ ബി വെരി ഹൈ. Called long term evaluation, or actually this is also known as OTE, that means LTE, long term evolution, provide mobile ultra broadband internet access to mobile service. Then the speciality of 4G is it offer high speed internet access. In seconds we can download a video file, that means in this generation the importance for downloading data from internet. Okay, it provides better data transfer rate. Then one of the key requirement of 4G is wireless IP based access system. Then the 4G access uses OFDMA. OF stands for orthogonal frequency division multiple access. That means here we are giving importance to data transfer rate. So we can make use of images and video files easily in fourth generation of mobile computing. So the technologies are different. In first generation there will be no technology, only analog signals were used. But in second 2G, the two concepts were introduced, that is GP, global system for mobile, and also CDMA, code division multiple access. At that time MMS introduced. 3GW, wide CDMA, that means the data transfer level was introduced. Data and also voice data, data and voice we can combine in a particular file. After that, fourth generation of mobile computing that uses orthogonal frequency division multiple access. So the concept, basic concept on each generation you want to study, because it's a very very important question, mobile computing and also different generations of mobile computing. Okay, hope you understood. So again we will revise the topics that we studied from this video. We started with mobile computing. Nowadays we are using mobile computer, mobiles for accessing internet. Then different generations of mobile phone. We started with first generation, second generation, third, fourth. Then all the services that we used in the generation also we discussed. Then you want to write one question in your notebook as a homework. Explain, briefly explain the various generations of mobile computing. Okay, it's an important question. Hope you understand concepts of mobile computing. The remaining sections are the mobile services that we will discuss in the next video. Okay, then thank you.